Good morning, thank you very much. My name is Jay Seneca, I'm representing Elsevier. After the wonderful, beautiful, clear accent of Ron, you're going to now have to try and understand, for those who follow English, my South African accent. So I hope you will succeed. Could you go to the next slide, please? I have three messages today. Since some of you might not know Elsevier, I'm going to briefly talk about who we are, very briefly, just to introduce us, as well as also share a few thoughts on why we feel really proud to be a partner of Rosatom. That was also mentioned this morning in the opening talk already. The second message I will share is I'm going to talk a bit about some of the challenges researchers, scientists, and engineers in all organizations, definitely also in Rosatom, face today. And then I'm going to talk about how practical tools, content, technology can actually help. So Ron talked about the critical importance of knowledge management, particularly mission-critical knowledge and the knowledge and the mindset required. And I believe Larry is going to talk more about some examples from other companies in the world also on knowledge capitalization. I'm going to talk a bit about practical content, tools, solutions that researchers use today, particularly in the nuclear industries. Next slide, please. Or next slide after this. So, first, who we are. Can we go to the next slide? The representing Elsevier, I'm particularly proud. I should take this off because this is confusing me. Representing Elsevier, I'm particularly proud to be here at this conference, also to be as an opportunity to meet so many people at Rosatom, even the incredibly deep and rich history that Rosatom has. This is a history that, you know, that is known for prominent scientific achievements through the decades. And it's something that in Elsevier we proud ourselves on as well. I'll get to that. Next slide, please. The other thing that I notice is that Rosatom has very clear values. It's a value-driven organization. And if you could click two more times. More, please. And one more time. Particularly the two values that stood out to me, because it's very linked to what we do in Elsevier, is the need to be one step ahead in knowledge and in technology. I said that driven value to be, we need to be at the forefront of technology, we need to be at the forefront of knowledge. At the same time, doing it in an efficient way. So the clear value, we need to be efficiently making use of our resources, which I understood as meaning capital, human, and of course knowledge resources. So that takes me to who we are as Elsevier. Go to the next slide. Slightly made between the two screens. So Elsevier is part of the RELX group. I'm not going to talk much about the RELX group, but RELX is the fourth largest digital content provider in the world. And we do one thing and one thing only, and that is we provide digital information solutions to professionals. Professionals in different industries. Elsevier is part of RELX, and Elsevier is the largest part of RELX. Elsevier focuses on scientific, technical, and medical information to professionals in those industries. In the area that I'm part of, Elsevier Research Solutions, we provide solutions to engineers, scientists, researchers. So information, workflow solution, tools that help them do their work more effectively. Can you move to the next slide? We started, some of you might know us, as a scientific publisher. For hundreds of years, we have published the latest and the greatest scientific discovery that goes through the normal scientific publishing process, peer-reviewed global journals. Many of the Nobel Prize winners published with Elsevier. We have more than 2,000 journals that we published, 50,000 books. So we're the source of content to the world of researchers, scientists, engineers. But we're not only a publisher. We've combined our knowledge and the content that we have with technology and analytics, and we create databases, workflow tools. We believe when you combine content with real advanced technology, you create tools that are really effective for researchers today. And I'm going to talk a bit more about why that's important, particularly about when we talk about the challenges that we have with too much information. So it's that ability to extract information using technologies, using the latest algorithms, using cloud-based solutions that help researchers actually make the most use of technology, of the content. And we have that in many forms in our various workflow and AWS tools. You see some of the examples on that slide. Could you click one more time, please? So when we talk about content, it is e-journals, e-books. When we talk about technology solutions, it is databases and workflow tools. And it, of course, all exists in the cloud. We're a digital company, we provide digital solutions. It's all cloud-based technologies that we provide. So that's who we are, and that was the introduction part. If you could move forward, please. So next I'm going to share a few thoughts on some of the challenges your researchers face, particularly with regards to information overload and increased competition. So if you can go to the next slide. I want to share with you some of the vantage points. I'm going to make some observations, and you might rightly ask, well, based on what do I share some of these observations? Could you click forward, please? So one of the sources of information that I have and that we base observations on, is that we're a publisher of 25% of the world's scientific outputs. Elsevier alone last year received more than 1 million article submissions. Each scientific article, of course, is progressing the knowledge and the science in that particular field. So that's a kind of representative sample of what we see of what research is being done everywhere in the world, every country, every university, government institutes, companies, and how it is then and how it's developing. The second thing is, we, through Science Direct, around 30% of the world's digital downloads and reading of this information happens. And so we see that as well. Last year we had 850 million article downloads on Science Direct. That means we know who reads what, how do they consume it, how do they interact with those articles, which part of the information do they find most relevant, where do they go next. We get a wealth of information that tells us how do people consume information. And then thirdly, through our Scopus database, which is the world's largest abstract and imagery database, we see not just our own publications and knowledge, but we see everything. Scopus indexes journals from all the publishers in the world. So we track what gets published everywhere, and we track citations. So we know who publishes with whom, who collaborates with whom, in a particular paper, is then citing another paper. We track 80,000 citations a day. That gives us immense insight in how the knowledge economy and the knowledge workers are actually progressing. So that's the background of how I share this information. Go to the next slide. So here's a fact. Last year, 2,662,425 papers were published, each one advancing science and knowledge in that particular field. So 2.6 million papers last year alone. Now, of course, no one can read all of that, and no one needs to or wants to read all of that. That's very clear. This is all disciplines, all fields. So the more relevant question, if you go to the next slide, is how long would it take if you're a researcher, or you're an engineer, or you're a scientist working at Rosatom, and you want to make sure that you read everything that gets published in your field of interest, just the area where you're working in, to make sure you stay up to date. How long will it take you? Well, this question was actually studied by researchers and published. They published the results in 2010. They looked at the field of echocardiography, and they made quite a few assumptions, essentially saying if you do nothing but read papers, you will read 10,000 papers in a year. But the problem is that once you've read all of those papers, it would have been, and it will take you 11 years then to read all the papers. And once you're done, there will be 82 more papers to be read. So if you go to the next slide, they concluded it will take you a lifetime. It is impossible to keep up. The interesting challenge, of course, that we have, if you go to the next slide, is when you ask researchers, and this was, we know it, but we've also done a study on it, is what do researchers care most about? Because there's so much information, because it's so critical, we work in a knowledge economy, they care most about missing out on critical information. Actually missing something that is really important to their project, to their research, to their particular investment that they need to know. And that's just a key challenge. It's very clear that humanly, we just cannot consume the information and make sure we don't miss out on everything. Though we try. So if you go to the next slide, year, we know that all the scientists, researchers, and engineers at Rosatom downloaded articles, downloaded and read articles on our SciDirect platform 75,685 times. So it's not that there's a, people are not reading information, they're reading information a lot. If you go to the next slide, but of course so are all other researchers and scientists and engineers. So for example, if you click one more time, the researchers at the Indira Gandhi Center of Atomic Research in the same time period downloaded 2.5 times more articles than all the Rosatom engineers and scientists and researchers combined. Everywhere in the world, people read, consume information, and need to keep up to date. Which, if you click one more time, please, brings me to the last part of my talk, is how can companies like Elsevier, but also other providers and other technology and information companies, help our engineers, our scientists, our researchers to stay one step ahead while increasing their efficiency. It's a continuous drive that we have to be more efficient. And we do it, and I'm going to use Elsevier examples because that's what I know. But of course the same applies to many other innovative technology-driven companies in this space. We do it, if you click one more time, by combining content, as I mentioned before, with best technology, best analytics, to drive improved outcomes, in particular in this case, in the relevant year, in the atomic energy research. So it's not having only fancy web-based technologies, it's not only having content, it doesn't help if we have books and journals sitting on a shelf and people cannot access information. It's combining it that makes our researchers effective. One more time, please. But what are the outcomes that we're talking about? It's helping our researchers stay one step ahead by making sure they have access to the right information at the right time, not just bombarding them with all the information. It is optimizing your collaboration. We all, every institute in the world, every university in the world that I speak to, everybody collaborates more and more. We talked about this more and more about the openness in this particular industry, in this field. We need to understand who we should collaborate with, where is it most optimal, and what the trends are in terms of research trends and competencies that we make sure we make the right choices. We need to respond quickly to the changing landscapes, regulations, etc. that is impacting our business because we operate in a global environment. And we need to make sure we use resources efficiently. We need to make sure that we manage and take the portfolio decisions when we do portfolio management, project management, investment in research and development projects efficiently using data, using fact-based decision making to make sure we optimally allocate those resources. So on the next slide, I'm going to go very quickly, don't take too much time, to a couple of examples from the Elsevier world. So on this slide, we know, for example, that Rosatom engineers, scientists and researchers access information, I mentioned already on the previous slides, 75,000 times last year, from all over the world. So we know, for example, your engineers, 22% of the time they downloaded information that originated in the United States. Next was Japan, next was China, next was France and Germany. Perhaps not surprising, but it's useful to understand where people, where the information that your researchers are most interested in originates from. On the next slide, but what is also important, we know that they find that information useful. When your researchers publish and they cite other research in their publications, 51% of the time it is the Elsevier publications. So they know that the information they get is useful, they actually use it in their own research. We also know when we track patents, that of all the patent applications that references Rosatom research, 53% of the time that research was published with Elsevier. So we know how they use it, we can track it in patents, and we know whether it's useful to them or not. If you go to the next slide. We also know that how we partner with Rosatom engineers in terms of the dissemination of their knowledge. So your engineers and scientists and researchers publish as well, and they want to make sure that they publish in a way that disseminates and share that knowledge in the widely most possible way, because that also leads to collaboration, advancement of science, etc. So we know, for example, your research is downloaded most in China, next United States, next Japan. If you go down the list, we also know Canada, Taiwan, Italy are keenly interested in the research being published by your researchers. On the next slide, I share, you know, I have an example of technology. So for example, I talked about the overload of information for researchers, and still they want to keep up with the latest. So what do we, and the same Google, Amazon, all the technology companies, they have all recommendation engines to help us find the information we're looking for. Finding the right scientific information, making sure it's the relevant information and you're not missing out, is mission critical for researchers and for scientists. So we invest a lot of that. We have a high-performance computing cluster running in the States. And we take all the signals, more than 6 billion of them a day, from all our databases, from all our tools, so how people interact with information, that we know what the profile is of what people interact with, what they're interested in, what they read, etc. We feed it into that, we crunch it daily, and that feeds a recommendation engine that when you are on the site and you're reading this, it tells you, you probably should be reading this as well, or you might be interested in that as well. We know that saves time. It saves significant man hours in terms of not having to search for that information. That's benefit number one. Benefit number two, it helps people make sure that they don't miss out by recommending stuff to them that might be relevant to them. I'll conclude on the next example. Go to the next slide. So, I talked briefly before about collaboration. So this is, for example, a snapshot of looking at all the publications published by Rosatom researchers and scientists again. Now we can go into many more detail here in terms of who collaborates with who, when they do that, how is that trend developing over time, what fields are they collaborating in, etc. I'm just sharing a bit of data here, but we know, for example, that 24% of the time when your engineers and scientists publish information, they do it in, they co-publish with people from other countries, researchers, scientists in other countries, 24% of the time. 33% of the time, it's co-published with a researcher or a scientist at another institute in Russia. And then you have the rest there. What is interesting, if you look to the far right here, is all those publications that are co-authored with researchers in other countries, they receive on average 11.1 citations per paper, compared to 1.8 for the papers all co-authored with other institutes in Russia. It's a 6-time increase in the citations they receive. And I have 1 minute left, which concludes, if you go two slides, click twice, one more, which brings me to my conclusion. So, quickly recap again, particularly given Rosatom's deep history in scientific delivery, and values on staying one step ahead and being efficient with resources. We're very proud to be a partner of Rosatom and to be here today. Your researchers face many challenges, including an overload of information and challenges to compete with researchers elsewhere in the world and in Russia, of course. And it's important to look at solutions that can help support your researchers stay ahead. You know, deploying the latest technology, the latest content, giving them the tools that they need to be successful. Thank you very much.